being from the Midwest, art was pretty much marginal to my experience. I had a fairly typical childhood. Church, Girl Scouts, summers in our family cabin by the lake in Michigan. In high school, I was a cheerleader. I even dated the co-captain of the football team. My father was a salesman. I suppose what you would call today a sales rep. Anyway, my dad always stressed the importance of establishing good human relationships. Being friendly was important to him, putting people at ease. They didn't call it this back then, but I guess what he was doing all along was networking. He had tons and tons of friends. Today, again, you would probably call them contacts. But I remember you couldn't walk down the street without half a dozen people greeting him and saying hello. And you know, he always had something specific to say to each one, like, is your wife out of the hospital yet? Or, I heard Terry pitched a no-hitter on Sunday. He not only knew all these people by first name, he even knew the names of their kids, their grandkids, their spouses, their siblings. He even knew the names of some of their pets. And you know what he sold? He sold the most boring things. He sold things like air filters and roof ventilators. But to him it was exciting, and I guess that's what made him so good at it. Now, in graduate school, I had this professor, this visiting artist from France. His name was Corrado Malaspina, who described my potential as something that lay beyond what he called the periphery of my limited, quote, limited, those were his words, my limited talents. It depressed me at first, but I took that to mean, though, that the professional success was not beyond my capabilities, but to achieve it, I had to find something outside the traditional forms of expression. And I think he saw, even back then, that my true strengths were not in how I was able to manipulate material or techniques or even concepts, but really, my true talents lie in my charm, my magnetism, my charisma. It was a sort of a road to Damascus moment for me where I stopped beating my head against the wall trying to improve my actual work, and I started in earnest to work on, for lack of a better term, my package. In any event, after I got my degree and I bounced around for a few years after graduate school, it dawned on me how impossible the task is to succeed as an artist, you know, on its own merits, on its own terms. So, in a panic, I enrolled in every workshop I could find. Seminars with ridiculous titles, these career-type motivational forums. One was called Realization and Resolve, 6 Steps Toward Success. They love alliteration in these things. Communicating our needs without appearing needy. I even signed up for some of these personal breakthrough programs, you know, the kind of things where you're virtually locked up with a group of strangers and all these bullying instructors trying to guide these wounded seekers and lost souls. In a way, it resembled graduate school. Yeah, so here I am, years later, and I've mastered the art of making appointments.